The Out of Bounds Show podcast is brought to you by Boar's Head, premium meats, cheeses, and hummus. Boar's Head, compromise elsewhere.
WRKS Pickens Jackson.
All systems go.
Live from the Whiskey 61 Lounge inside the Bank Plus Studio.
This is now recorded.
Live in the studio, it's the Out of Bounds Show with Bo Bounds.
Streaming live worldwide on the Out of Bounds radio app.
And on your radio at ESPN 105.9.
All set? Let's go.
The Zone.
Oh, man. It's already Tuesday. What in the world happened? Good morning, good morning. Welcome in. Thanks for making us your SEC football show of choice. Sports and entertainment show of choice. We are the Out of Bounds Show. 105.9 The Zone, ESPN. We're going to have Breezy Oaks Ranch. BreezyOaksRanch.com in the house in the 9 o'clock hour. They're cooking a bunch of food. We already lit the egg, whatever it is, the Gourmet Guru Grill downstairs. So they'll throw some good food on there. I'm not sure exactly what they're going to do, but whatever it is, it'll be good. Looking forward to that. Hey, thanks for hanging out with us on the dial, ESPN 105.9 The Zone, and also streaming the show wherever you are. TheZone1059.com. And the Out of Bounds radio app. Would love for you to download that. That would be super cool for us. It'll keep food on Blake's table. If you download the Out of Bounds radio app, keep food on, or cold beer, whatever it is. Blake had a large time. He was the social chairman on Saturday, so he had a big time celebrating himself in Davis Wade Stadium.
Somebody should.
That's right. That's right. You can hit us up on the Farm Bureau Insurance call-in line, 601-707-3750. Twitter handle at Bo Bounds. And the text line, 601-885-3776. 885-3776 is brought to you by AgUp. AgUp.com. That's where you'll find your next John Deere tractor to manage your land. AgUp.com, Mississippi Ag. Two locations, Canton and Pearl, 16 total. About to be 18. Welcome in. Got a good show lined up for you today. We've got some topics. Believe it or not, you know, a Southern Cal, you know, when Southern Cal is good, it makes college football better. Just like when the Texas Longhorns are good, it makes... They're not right now. Neither team is. But it makes it better. And Texas made a good hire this past offseason. And then, you know, Southern Cal just fired their coach yesterday. I know. They kept him years too long. You don't know who he is because you're not interested and he's not interesting. Clay Helton was the coach for like 6 years out there. Really nothing happened. And that's, I think, why we stopped talking about the Pac-12 to a certain extent, because... You know, Oregon sounds good, and the jerseys and the Nike thing had some legs. But let's be honest, even with the win over Ohio State on Saturday, it's about Southern Cal being good in that conference. It's not about Oregon. It's not about Stanford. It's not about UCLA. It's about, you know, Southern Cal being good in that conference. So it's interesting. You know, we know how much wealth Southern Cal, you know, their alumni base is. Super wealthy. I mean, just, we were looking up before the show. They have one alum, Salesforce.com CEO is worth $8 billion. I'm looking right here, 20 most notable. It's a who's who. A billionaire out there, this is going to sound weird. A billionaire out there is not that big a deal, really. I mean, I hope the Sun Belt gets to that point.
Yeah. They have the seventh most billionaires in the world in terms of universities.
Again, just filthy, filthy That's rich insane. Alumni base, right? I mean, you know, L.A. boomed 100 years ago, and entertainment and technology and all the other stuff going on. And so when you look at this list, It's crazy that they are. There is some discussion and debate within their maybe leadership and alumni base as to whether they want to go pay a buyout of a coach of $10 million, which is nothing. If that's the way you look at is if that's the lens you're using or the blueprint at Southern Cal, you're not going to win. You're not committed to winning. It's still about Hollywood and Netflix and Amazon and all the other things going on out there or in the Bay Area, which is just a little, you know, plane ride. And so all the .com that they've done, all the different things that they've got going on. And look, I love going out there. Hopefully they'll get their act together with COVID. Obviously they've self-inflicted all this stuff with poor leadership and so on, but it's a super, I'd rather go there than New York. And I have people, you know, I have friends who love to go to New York and blah, blah, and I like New York, but I'd rather go to LA. I like that it's spread out. I like that it's close to a beach. I like some of the other things out there. But if the one thing that you'll find as you roam around town is that it's Lakers. It's Lakers, Lakers, and now it's NFL. Rams, Chargers are trying to find some real estate out there. But you're Southern Cal. You got billionaire after billionaire after billionaire, and you're getting bogged down on an $8, $10, $12 million dollar buyout. It's irrelevant if you win. It doesn't matter. It doesn't.
You make it back in what, a season and a half?
Maybe, yeah, a season. A home game? I don't know.
If you become good.
One dinner with six guys?
Yeah.
I mean, these guys are capable of all writing you $100 million-plus gifts because they're multi-billionaires. So what is $10 million at the end of the day? I understand you went through the academic scandal, okay? And I understand that the elites on the East and West Coast have thought, well, the rules don't apply to us. We have to get our kids into these schools, right? And we don't want the flyover state kids to, I mean, they don't deserve to go to, you know, Southern Cal or Brown or Cornell or Stanford. But, and so, you know, we were talking to people in the business a couple of years ago when that story broke, and I asked some people, they're like, you have no idea. They didn't even scratch 0.001% of parents paying people to get their kids into school on the East and West Coast. It's no wonder they've handled COVID the way they have. It's funny. They're very linear and very educated.
And very misguided.
Oh God. I mean, it's so bad. It's so embarrassing what they've done the last 18 months. And so what are you doing if you're Southern Cal? Do you want to be a big boy program? Do you want to commit? Do you want to get in the mix of the college football playoff? Do you want to help the Pac-12 have a better opportunity to score a better media rights deal? $10 million is nothing. $12 million is nothing. So we'll see what they decide to do. You could argue it's the best job in college football. But, Bo, Alabama went. Alabama's not the best job in college football. Nick Saban is amazing.
Yeah.
Alabama's in a small state, still has to fight Auburn, has to work 20 times harder than they have to out in Los Angeles to get players and fight in the SEC and all that. Is Alabama a really good job? Yeah. I wouldn't even have it one. I wouldn't have it two. You know, Ohio State's about, as far as path of least resistance, if you don't have one, you know, the best coach of all time at your university right now in Saban, then as far as path of least resistance, Southern Cal, Ohio State, Texas while they're in the Big 12, Clemson while they're in the ACC, those path of least resistance, those jobs have it. Don't you agree, Blake?
Wholeheartedly. And I think with USC, like what you're not mentioning too is, they haven't even been good, and they've been competing in the Pac-12.
Right.
If Alabama loses Saban, you know, who knows where you fall back to. A half step is like 10 steps in the SEC. USC is, if they do this, it's more expensive to not make a good hire than it is to spend $10 million on a buyout.
So what will their new athletic director do in Cincinnati, from Cincinnati? He hired Luke Fickell. Now, Luke Fickell's a good coach. He's got a great QB. He's from Ohio. He's an Ohio State guy. They're going to the Big 12. I don't know. Let's discuss on the big board. Good morning. Welcome in. Show is powered by the Golden Moon Casino Sportsbook.
The Out of Bounds Show podcast is powered by Breezy Oaks Ranch. For Mississippi-raised premium Wagyu beef and heritage pork shipped straight to your door, visit BreezyOaksRanch.com.
What's on the big board?
Oh, good morning. Welcome in. The show is brought to you by the award-winning Dancing Rabbit Golf Club. DancingRabbitGolf.com. DancingRabbitGolf.com. Blake, we've got a got several gift certificates back there for a group of four to play for free. Let's give that away today via the AgUp.com text line. Manage your land with a John Deere tractor from Mississippi Ag. Dancing Rabbit Golf Club. Four of y'all. Four women, four men, two and two, whatever it is. Go up there and play Azaleas in the Oaks, or the Oaks, and have a great time. Hit the Golden Moon Casino Sportsbook. And then, of course, they've got my favorite old-style Vegas steakhouse, Philip M's. Sit in the bar. It's so cool. Or if it's a crew of you, go over there in the wine room. That's a cool spot. I think that's where the chief hangs out. I don't blame him. That is a pretty room. Very, very cool. We ate there, I guess, last year with the Tito's crew. That was fun. Live in the Bank Plus studio. Blake, what's up, bud?
Well, I was just going to ask. The Texans already hot and bothered.
Oh, okay.
Hot and bothered about
great
USC job being open. I mean,
Lane train to Southern Cal.
Right?
Is that what they want us to
right?
say?
Right. Everybody's asking.
Well, you know, it's going to be interesting to see. Obviously, Lane's already been the head coach out there. And it didn't go bad. It just didn't. It just wasn't great. And it was back when Lane was super immature and too cocky and was bouncing around jobs left and right. Now, I give him credit. He took the job. They were under massive probation. He did win the Pac-12 South. He would have played in the Pac-12 championship game. I mean, he went 10-2 one year. Da-da-da-da-da. All right? And he was close to getting it done. You could argue he shouldn't have been fired on the tarmac. I mean, you know, from there they went to Ed Orgeron as the interim. From there they hired Steve Sarkisian after that season. Steve had some issues off the field, as have been documented. And from there, Sarkisian got removed. And then they gave the interim to Clay Helton. And then for some reason, they decided to hire him for like 6 years. I don't know. It amazes me that a university like that with a, Blake, will you look it up, please? Their endowment. With a multi-billion dollar endowment and the success of their alums would go through what they've been through. But I've said this on the air before. When I was growing up, Southern Cal wasn't in the 80s and the 90s. Now, 60s and 70s, McKay and some other guys, John Robinson, so on, they won. They won. They had some QBs. They had OJ. I mean, they had some teams. 80s and 90s, poof.
They were actually terrible.
They totally disappeared. I'll go back to when I was a kid, 83, 84, you know, 10 years old, getting into stuff, football, Oklahoma, Nebraska, eventually Florida State, Miami. We didn't really have a power in the 80s in the SEC. Auburn danced around the title. Coach Paul Bear Bryant had stepped down and passed away, so we didn't really have a top three or four program, although Auburn danced in that space a lot. So when I was growing up, Blake, it was Oklahoma.
Yeah.
It was Nebraska.
Yeah.
It eventually became Florida State. Joe Paul grabbed two natties in the 80s.
That's right.
There was a little bit of Bobby Knight, the game passing by after 86. And then Miami became a power, but it was not the SEC. And it was not Southern Cal on a 20-year run until Pete Carroll was hired.
From Blake. 1980 to 2001. Southern Cal, and 2001 was the first year of Pete Carroll. From 1980 to 2001, Southern Cal had one 10-win season.
That's hard to do in a place like Southern Cal.
I actually didn't know it was that bad.
And it was the Pac-8. See, this is hard for you to because you were born in the 90s. Blake, it was the Pac-8, and Washington dominated. Don James, Nick Saban's mentor, was up in the middle of nowhere, probably with no budget. Okay? And Washington had some years, and a couple other teams in the Pac-8. It was before it was even the Pac-10 or the Pac-12. You know, and Oregon was awful. Remember, Greg Byrne's dad, Bill Byrne, they called him Bill the Builder. So he actually got, you know, fundraising and facilities and so on, right? Bill Byrne took over at Oregon and hired Rich Brooks, which got it going. And then they hired, who was the dude before Kelly with the cool name? Bertelli or, anyway, I've said his name 94 times on the air. And they got, but my point is Oregon wasn't any good. It took Rich Brooks years. Bill Byrne was very patient. That was back when you could be a patient with the coach.
Belotti was the AD that you were thinking of. Well, Belotti
was the head coach after Rich Brooks.
He was also AD.
Yeah, he took over for about a year and a half as AD. But Belotti's the one that put them on the map
as head coach.
And then they hired Chip Kelly as the OC, which made that, you know, an easy transition when Belotti decided to do his thing. Hey, another story here is Bama and Florida. Bama and Florida this weekend. Let me give you all the Airbnb rates. Oh. I'm looking at one spot for $4,000 for the weekend. Looking at another spot for $4,000 for the weekend in Gainesville. I'm looking at another spot for $3,500. So if anybody wants to take a road trip, just let us know. As long as you have a King Air, and you'll pick up that tab. We'll do everything. I'll bring some Tito's, right? And Blake said we'll pack some Breezy Oaks Ranch, you know, fillets and ribeyes and New York strips. But as long as y'all foot the bill for about, you know, the King Air is probably going to be $10,000, and that Airbnb $14,000 for you. $400 or $500 for us. We're in. We'll go to Gainesville with you for the weekend. So 4,000, 4,000, 3,500, 2,800 Airbnb in Gainesville, Florida for the weekend if you want to go and hang out and watch the Alabama Crimson Tide and the Florida Gators. Wow.
Tickets will be the cheapest part.
No kidding.
You can find tickets for $150 right now.
Wow. That must be up in the nosebleed in the swamp.
Sunshine end zone.
I can't believe that. Wow. Okay. That actually really surprises me that they're that. I guess that's the cheapest ticket.
Yes, the cheapest.
Well, when you find the most expensive, tell me what the most expensive is for the next segment on StubHub. And I hope it's a big number just because that would be really cool.
It is.
Okay. Out of Bounds, 105.9 The Zone, ESPN. Brought to you by Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center on Fortification and Lakeland Drive, Flowood, New Surgery Center and Clinic, MississippiSportsMedicine.com. MississippiSportsMedicine.com. Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center. Any age, any sport, any injury, they've got you covered. Speaking of, Blake Scott is... our sports injuries that we discuss are brought to you by Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center. Blake, what's the latest? I saw you dancing around on... I didn't have a lot of time on Twitter yesterday, but I saw you dance around on the Zach Martin thing.
Yes.
What? All right. He is one of Dak Prescott's most valuable assets as far as an offensive lineman in front of him. That trio has missed like 100 games the last few years. What is the latest on Zach Martin?
He is supposed to be back ASAP because of the failed COVID test last week. They think he's going to be back. What's going to hurt is now Lyle Collins, the right tackle, is having to miss 5 weeks for substance abuse, quote unquote, because he missed a test, not failed one, missed a test from the NFL because he was in quarantine because he's close proximity to Zach Martin. Cowboys are trying to figure out how that's possible, but, you know.
So he's in quarantine, which is nonsense. He's had the vaccine.
But it means he can't go to the testing. So how is he going to be punished for missing the test?
I don't understand. Can somebody help me here?
Great question. Great question.
All right, agup.com text line. Agup, Mississippi Ag. Agup.com. John Deere America's Tractor text line, 601-885-3776. We'll give you the guest list next. The Out of Bounds Show podcast is presented by Edwin Watts Golf Shop on County Line Road. Your golf game starts with Edwin Watts Golf Shop.
Let's do it.
This is the SEC Insider Hit. And it's presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue.
Good morning. Welcome in. 26 million viewers across various platforms. 26 million. Watch the Dallas Cowboys and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Most watched NFL kickoff game since 2015. 26 million viewers across various platforms. How about that? It's a pretty good number. Whew. NFL. I'd like to know from our listeners, did you watch Peyton and Eli last night on the Monday Night Football telecast, simulcast, if you will? Did you watch Peyton and Eli? I don't really have to say their last name, but Manning. I'd love to hear from you on the AgUp, agup.com text line. 601-885-3776. Manage your land with a John Deere tractor from AgUp, agup.com, Mississippi Ag. Good morning. Welcome in. Hope you're doing well. Thanks for hanging out with us. We'll have Michael Katz, Ole Miss Insider, djournal.com. Michael Katz at 8 a.m. on Matt Corral, Lane Train. Some of the things happening in Oxford. They're 2-0. They will host the Tulane Green Wave this weekend at 7 o'clock on ESPN2. So for those of you who are into power tailgating, you get your wish early in the season.
There you go.
You get a 7 o'clock game. So you can get out there at noon, 1 or 2, and rip and run. The Grove should be rocking, a lot of excitement. And the Lane Train has kind of flipped the script from where Ole Miss was the last couple of years. And they will host the Tulane Green Wave this weekend. And Mississippi State will travel on the road to beautiful Liberty Bowl Stadium and Memphis, and they will play before Ole Miss on the same channel, ESPN2. So dogs at 3 on the road, not but an hour up the road from Oxford, and then Ole Miss at 7 on ESPN2. We are the Out of Bounds Show, 105.9 The Zone, ESPN, WRKS. Your SEC Insider Hit this morning is brought to you by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue. The official health care provider of the Out of Bounds Show, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Mississippi. Did you watch Peyton and Eli? Also, do you want to get in the mix on the four rounds of golf to Dancing Rabbit Golf Club that we're giving away today? You got to text us on the AgUp text line, agup.com, 601-885-3776. If you want a few rounds of golf, right, get you a foursome, head up to award-winning Dancing Rabbit Golf Club, maybe even do a stay and play, and then also hit the Golden Moon Casino Sportsbook, which is also a sports bar. It's a great layout. TVs everywhere, cool bar, they have food. I mean, it's fun on game day. It's fun on a Thursday night when you've got football, Saturday night, Sunday, Monday type deal. Or if you're just, as a salesperson, you're going through that area and you want to drop a little cheddar, a little change, some ducats, according to Blake Mania, on the game this weekend, whether it's $25 or $2,500. The Golden Moon Casino Sportsbook and Pearl River Resort. We're going to be there in a few weeks. I'll have to get that date exactly right. I was talking to Ron yesterday, so we're looking forward to that. Smash a great dinner at Philip M's and broadcast from the Golden Moon Casino Sportsbook, Pearl River Resort. Download the PRR Sports app.
Yes.
If you'll go ahead and down, first of all, you have the lines right there, okay? And you can check your neighborhood bookie too, right? But
ask him why his lines are so
exactly. PRR, you should, PRR Sports, because they don't know what they're doing to a certain extent. But PRR Sports app, and as soon as you get on the property, like if you're at Philip M's and you're going through a steak and the saffron chowder and, you know, maybe some crab legs and some shrimp and all the stuff that they do, you don't want to hustle over to the Golden Moon Casino Sportsbook. I mean, you're enjoying a glass of whatever, Merlot or Four Roses bourbon, and you can put, you can just... Bam.
That's right.
You just bet on, you know, Auburn and Penn State. How about that? And you didn't move. The only thing you had to move was your fork out of the way, and then you're good to go. Yeah. So PRR Sports app. You obviously had something on your mind. What's up?
Oh, no, I'm excited. You're talking about PRR. We haven't been. I feel like I haven't been in forever. I mean, we didn't really get much in last year because all the craziness. So, I mean, I'm pumped up. I love that place. What Chris and them have done, and Ryan, obviously, they've killed it. At the sports book,
we got to get Hopwood on the show. He's opening another sports book.
Does anybody work harder than that? That dude works that like a crazy person.
Guy does work like he, but he's also off the charts bright. They made a great hire bringing him in, and other when you have other reservations and asking to come in and set up their sports book. I think he's in Wyoming, but he may be coming back here soon. So we'll see how that works. There's a new casino opening somewhere out west.
You're saying he's their Joe Brady? Is that what you're saying?
Yes, I am. That's exactly what I'm saying.
Who's going to be Southern Cal's Joe Brady? Or maybe the better
maybe
answer.
They'll hire Joe Brady.
Yeah, I don't know. Look, hey, the only name on Bruce Feldman with The Athletic, the only name that even intrigues me a little bit, because he listed, like, Mario Cristobal. I don't know about that.
Right.
He listed Matt Campbell, which, like, has the shine not worn off? I know he's doing a good job, but, like, every time they have a big game, they lose. So I don't know about that one. That's interesting. You know what name popped up that was interesting to me, though?
What?
James Franklin.
His name always comes up.
Right? An interesting dynamic. I don't think of James Franklin as a West Coast guy. Do you?
I think James Franklin could be great at Southern Cal in LA. I mean, he's got a lot of, you know, mojo and moxie, and he's a cool dude. Yeah, I think that you could, even though he's out in the middle of nowhere at Penn State right now, I think you could drop him in LA at Southern Cal and he could, boom, he wouldn't miss a beat. He's very engaging, great personality, smart, all the things you need. I think he's a big enough name to handle the whole thing and has been through enough to win there. But look, you got James Franklin. You mentioned Matt Campbell, but you got Luke Fickell. Mike Bone is their athletic director. He was at Cincinnati. He hired Luke Fickell.
Yep.
Luke doesn't have quite the pop, if you will, that James Franklin does, or Lane Kiffin. Steve Sarkisian's not leaving Texas. If they're not willing to buy anybody out, nobody's leaving anywhere for the most part. They would just have to go with a...
Tony Elliott?
That makes no sense to me.
That name is on Feldman's list, too.
I saw it. And so Tony Elliott has never coached anywhere outside of South Carolina.
Clemson offensive coordinator.
Right. And was the co-OC with Jeff Scott for years until Jeff Scott took the South Florida job.
That's right.
Why, if I'm Southern Cal, would I have to go hire Tony Elliott, the OC at Clemson? Maybe Tony's going to be great, but he's just now by himself, and I need him to get it done with Clemson's offense without it being he and Jeff Scott.
Yeah.
Plus, I don't know why I would have to make that move. I don't think Chris Peterson will come out of retirement. For our listeners, he was at Boise State and then Washington for years. I mean, just people are super, super, super high on Chris Peterson. I don't think he comes out of retirement. Bob Stoops is not coming out of retirement to go to L.A. Mm-mm. And at 60 years old, he's already made a ton of money. And he's on Fox Sports. He followed Urban Meyer, which was not a great, I mean, Bob Stoops is a nice guy, but he's not Urban Meyer on TV. Anyway, Bob Stoops is not coming out of retirement. So you really have to ask the question, you know, of course, Dan Mullen's name was floated. And we'll get into the SI Sports Illustrated article on Scott Strickland and Dan Mullen and how Mullen ended up at Florida here in a minute. And that got a lot of people all hot and bothered again yesterday. Ross Dellinger dropped a piece, SI.com. Dan Mullen, Chip Kelly, Scott Frost, and the coaching search that remade Florida football. That was by Ross Dellinger. It dropped yesterday. And it had people talking within the Southeastern Conference. So the Southern Cal job is open. You could argue it's the number one job in the country. And yet they have floundered around for years. Pre-Pete Carroll and post-Pete Carroll, they have not gotten it done in a super weak Pac-12. And we need West Coast to, you know, we need that brand to be good and a part of the conversation and at least make a college football playoff every now and then.
Once.
You know? I mean, right now, UCLA has the much better. Obviously, this morning, Southern Cal has an interim coach. But even prior to Clay Helton's firing yesterday morning, Chip Kelly is light years better than Clay Helton. And most of you don't know who Clay Helton is, and you don't have any. You shouldn't. But they have now gone through Lane Kiffin, Steve Sarkisian, and Clay Helton. Now, Lane and Sark are different today than what they were years ago when they took the Southern Cal job. Sark wouldn't leave Texas. Would Lane leave Ole Miss? Who knows? It would also be about, is Southern Cal even willing to consider big buyouts? A lot of these coaches have big buyouts in their contract. For Southern Cal, it's a drop in the bucket. We mentioned earlier, they have several alums worth $6, $7, $8+ billion. And they have, I don't know how many worth, and this is a big deal in this state, but out there, it's worth several hundred million, okay? So when you take their top 100 donors, and if you took their net worth as a whole, you know, it would be billions and billions and billions of dollars. So dropping 10, 12, 14 million is not a big deal. They're a private university. They can do what they want when they want. And they have an endowment.
$5.7 billion.
So they have a $5.7 billion endowment. Wouldn't you love to be one of the firms that is managing that money?
They spend $784 million annually on research grants out of that endowment.
That's incredible.
That's an insane number.
So in other words, the bulk of their professors and deans and all that are endowed.
Yep.
And that's the whole, you know, that's the money shot, so to speak. Frees up money for other things. And then, of course, they can pay, you know, a dean. I don't know what that number would be. $500,000 or $600,000,
whatever,
maybe.
Whatever they want.
Yeah, whatever they want. An engineering dean, a business dean, you know, whatever. What do you have?
Dean from Brandon goes, Coach O returns to Southern Cal.
Oh, gosh. Oh, no. What just happened?
That's fantastic. Oh, man.
What happened there?
That's brutal.
You know, this is a year where Miami could open up. Southern Cal's already open, and Miami could open up. We feel like in the Southeastern Conference, because we've had so many hires as of late, that most everybody's going to stand pat unless Ogeron absolutely steps in big, big Cal manure just on a weekly basis.
Yeah.
Now, he's kind of done that already with some off-the-field, on-the-field stuff. I mean, he is who he is. This whole whatever.
Have you seen the latest out of LSU with off-the-field issues?
Talk to me.
John Emery, former number one running back, has been deemed academically ineligible. LSU football PR, so to speak, the marketing department, came out and said, you know, Emery is ineligible academically because he was signed up for the wrong class and something got messed up, and so he's now deemed ineligible. Jacob Hester has come out, former LSU great, wore number 18, part of that legacy, last great fullback in the NFL. I love that guy.
Jacob, my main man, Hester.
We have his signature on that helmet right there.
Oh, yeah, we do.
He does a show in Baton Rouge now on local radio and Sirius XM. Hester does. He came out yesterday and said that LSU is lying and that John Emery is not out because he did not sign up for the wrong class. He's academically ineligible for other reasons.
He blatantly came out and said, if Jacob Hester, who is a part of the fold, let me explain to you why that's
important. He's a mouthpiece for LSU.
Well, I was about to say, let me explain to you why that's important. That doesn't happen under most head coaches at LSU.
No.
They are buttoned up.
So that tells me they know, all right, Jacob doesn't go against the grain. Jordy Collada will, but Jordy is not a former player.
Correct.
Okay? When you're a former player, it's a different deal, right?
He's in the building probably five times a week. I mean, the dude's, he's all over that place.
He won a national title. He played for Saban. They love him, blah, blah, blah. No doubt. I mean, went on to play in the NFL and so on. So we're talking about Jacob Hester. He's on Baton Rouge Sports Talk Radio, and he basically called out the LSU, athletic department for lying about John Emery. And if you remember, John Emery came down to LSU and Mississippi State. And LSU at the final hour really made the push. If they do that, they're going to win. And Emery is a talented running back at LSU. So if you've got Jacob Hester, a former player who's wildly popular, calling your blank out.
That's not good.
No, it's not.
That shows me that Orgeron has much less control than even we realize.
And that tells me that they know.
He's done.
Yep. Because I told you, when the Baton Rouge Advocate went against him.
It was you're in trouble.
You
they don't do that.
They don't.
They
take a call. It's much like the, you know, for decades, Ole Miss Media Relations to the Clarion Ledger. They take a call and they're like, here's what we want you to say. And to do that over John Emery and whatever is going on, Blake, that's a big deal. And it tells you that there's so much blood in the water around Orgeron, he's not going to be able to get back in the boat and away from the Sharks. It's just a matter. So if you get LA, if you've got Southern Cal open, if Miami opens up, and if this thing gets toxic enough that LSU, he may get one more, though. Again, we're so close to the glory days of the 15-0 and the Joe Burrow and Joe Brady. He may be able to survive one more. I think he's done at the end of 2022, okay?
Yeah, if you had to bet 2022 or not.
Okay, now, maybe he's got so much toxicity around him that he can't. And, again, there's so much blood in the water that he's not going to be able to fight off the Sharks. We'll see.
Yeah. It's incredibly interesting what could happen here, but the lack of control is pretty, you know, unique at LSU. This just doesn't happen. I mean, even Les Miles, for all of his issues, still had control of kind of the narrative by the time he was leaving. And he was a terrible person off the field. So incredible that this is coming out, and that Jake, to me, that was the nail in the coffin. Like you said, the Advocate is a big red flag. Jacob Hester, a former player, putting that out on social media and just kind of being flat line with
it. It would be like Dak Prescott hammering the head coach at Mississippi State, or Eli Manning going at the head football coach at Ole Miss.
Correct.
I mean, they're not going to do that unless they absolutely know there's a scandal and there's all this stuff going on that, you know,
even
that you
then
need to
they
cut
may
the
not do
right.
It. Yeah.
Yeah. Even then, former player. Look, when I called out Ron Polk 100 years ago, I got a lot of brushback.
Correct.
Okay, because it wasn't allowed. You weren't.
Well, players love their coach.
Absolutely.
More often than not, players love, regardless of what else.
And I was right. I knew that the program was a sinking ship.
Yeah.
Okay. They didn't want to acknowledge that. So if Eli or Dak looked at, let's say they actually, I'm talking about post-career.
Correct.
Okay?
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you're around the Starkville, Oxford area. You're there all the time.
Yeah.
You know, you're heavily involved more so than trying to play 17 NFL games a year and being in New York and Dallas 11 out of 12 months out of the year. If one of those goes out publicly, different if you're at a steakhouse in Oxford and Starkville and saying, I don't have faith in this coach. But if you come out publicly
and
say
it's in black and white on the interwebs, it exists. And then he stood by it because he got a ton of brushback from it. Absolutely. I think it's incredible. Here's my other question to you.
Ed Orgeron, does he get one more year or is he done at the end of 2022?
Well, let me ask you this question. Scott Woodward, athletic director at LSU, is a freak. He is a cutthroat shark. He went and got Mulkey. The guy is a good AD, I think. If he sees that Southern Cal's open and he has it in the waters, and he would know better than even we would know probably, that Miami might be coming open, LSU's not going to be outbid by Miami. They're certainly not going to be outbid by Southern Cal, I don't think, because no. LSU's willing to pay 10 times market rate right. to beat you. Right. They don't care.
Right.
They may not have as many billionaires, but they'll find the money.
Oh, yeah. They got plenty.
Don't you think it pushes Scott Woodward's hand to say, hey, maybe what's the difference in getting rid of Orgeron now versus in another year, right? It only prolongs, you know, why wait for your arm to keep decaying? Why not just go ahead and cut it off and get growing the new one?
Well, and I think that's a good point. And I don't know what they know. I don't know everything that Scott has in front of him as far as the on and off the field stuff. But if John Emery's parents are really suing LSU, and
that's going to be depositions,
yeah,
public record.
And well, and Ogeron's already tied into the Title IX sexual misconduct scandal. So I don't know if John Emery and them actually do this, or if maybe there's a payment to them at some point and this thing goes away or whatever. But this could get crazy. So Southern Cal's open. Miami may be open.
It's got to be.
LSU is either going to be open this year or next, and then we'll kind of work back from there.
What's the better? If you're a head coach, which job would you take right now, LSU or Southern Cal?
Southern Cal.
And you feel super confident about
that? I don't. I think both have been run poorly. They've both been through scandals, both academic and otherwise. You know, they've had to pay an enormous amount of money via legal fees and otherwise, but they've, you know, they're both, again, the money continues to pour into those type universities and endowments. So I can't tell you for sure what, but I think Southern Cal, the LA metro area, even though Louisiana produces crazy talent for the population they have, even more so than Mississippi, and we produce incredible athletes across the board. But in LA, metro area, Southern Cal, not as many monsters in the Pac-12.
Yeah.
I'm going Southern
Cal. No Alabama.
And if you're going to pay me $7-8 million, I can live in Manhattan Beach.
Yeah.
And life can be pretty good if I find a quarterback and figure it out.
I'm with you. Yeah. I agree. Just not playing Alabama alone.
Right.
Yeah. 100% agree with that.
Knowing that I get to play Arizona and Cal Berkeley. And Washington State,
yeah,
and exactly. Oregon State, yeah. and place, you know, teams like that.
And whatever two scrubs they add to get to 14, because they're going to need to.
Yeah, Montana State,
yeah.
UNLV, whatever.
Yeah.
Out of Bounds, 105.9 The Zone, ESPN, brought to you by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue. The official healthcare provider of the Out of Bounds show. Want to welcome you in, say good morning. We'll have Michael Katz on, Ole Miss Insider, coming up in, well, to be exact, 8 minutes. In the next segment, Michael Katz, DJournal.com, Ole Miss Insider on Ole Miss Tulane, 7 o'clock, ESPN2, this Saturday night. Now, as soon as Ole Miss plays that game, they get a week off. And then they get ready to go to Bama. So we fully expect Ole Miss to win this weekend, but Tulane may move it some. We'll see what Michael Pratt, the quarterback for the Tulane Green Wave, and Willie Fritz and Chip Long. Chip Long is the offensive coordinator for the Tulane Green Wave. A lot of people love him as a young up-and-comer. I think he was roommates with Will Hall at North Alabama. Ended up several years later getting the offensive coordinator job at Notre Dame. A lot of people still scratching their head as to why he was let go there, considering the numbers they threw up. And he is now the offensive coordinator for the Tulane Green Wave. People think he's a star in the industry. Tulane at Ole Miss, 7 o'clock, ESPN2, Vault Hemingway Stadium. The Out of Bounds Show, brought to you by Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center. Michael Katz, Ole Miss Insider, DJournal.com. Coming up next on the Modelo Guest Line.